All right, that's where I gotta go.
My legs went numb. I don't want to grab the post, so I wouldn't fall and slam right on the post.
Okay, you guys, don't try this at home. He thinks he's a spring chicken, and he is not.
His leg's gonna hurt tomorrow. He's not used to this. It served him right, having all this junk. He's just like his dad. I can't. Yeah, I know. You should have just left it up there like I told you to. Oh, no.
Okay.
be careful. Make sure you got that thing clipped tight.
The hyper dump falls all up and just cut it off.
What'd he say?
Do you have it up there with you?
Huh?
Do you have it with you?
No, I thought I should have brought it up.
Should have brought what up?
You want me to go grab it?
No, I think I could,
What?
Sounds though.
Can you hear him? You're just flapping in the breeze. We can't hear you down here.
Do you want me to go down and get it?
Yeah.
He said, yeah.
There should be a fresh battery right laying on the side, on the right-hand side of the cabinet.
Alright.
And I think it's got a metal blade in it.
You'd stay on the ground when you're doing your thing.
What?
I said, I wish you'd stay on the ground when you're doing your thing. That is way too dangerous. Thank you. don't you sell that thing and get it out of the yard?
Because it's holding the star.
Huh?
It's holding the star.
We don't need no star. Then you won't have to climb up and down it. That's a smart thing to do. I'm shorter than that thing is. Oh, cheapers, I got on this and can't get off.
Okay, right hand side on the back, there's a red button.
Don't disturb it because I got it all set.
Oh, shoot!
Did you turn it off?
I see a red button, but. God, I gotta stand upside down. Okay. Now he's cutting it off from the top. We got it all tied up to bring down.
Turn the camera on again, too.
It's on!
Gonna have you turn the camera
on. It's on!
Oh.
Ah!
Be careful! Watch the blade on this side, it's bending. Now just carry it down with you.
Thank you.
fast as I can.
That's where I said don't make it difficult.
Okay. I'm holding that.
Down on the ground.
Okay.
Got it?
Let go, I got it.
I was out of rope, I couldn't hold it anymore. You don't ask a short person to help you when you're doing this. Now be careful coming down.
Why would I be careful?
Because I want to irritate you for the rest of your life.
You were told to and you're going to listen?
That's what I was put on this earth for, and I think I'm going to do a good job of it.
So far.
I don't know the end except this again.
Thank you. I made it. I'm safe. Okay, got it in the garage and clamped in the vise. Gonna look it over and see what failed. And make sure these blades are the same. Here's one of the other blades, and just as I thought, they're identical. Just these were white, and these are black. It does still turn, and it doesn't make horrible noises. And it would, if the wind was really ripping, it would turn, and it did make electric, but most of the time it didn't. And I don't know if you're going to be able to see or not, but back in here, let's see, this wire's probably in the way. Okay, you can see that bearing. Hopefully you can see it. It's missing some balls. And apparently when the balls come off, it popped the shield out. There, the magnet just sucked it over. There you can see. That's why it wouldn't turn, because the magnet would hold it. So, I think I built this about 10 years ago. It's a 4-pole, I think it was a 24-volt military motor off of something, surplus. And took a piece of casing, slid it so it would pinch in there. And I made the tail so that it would, let me back up a ways, the tail would turn out of the wind like this with a cable. And that cable is here. It rusted off a few years ago. And it was one of those coated ones too, but I guess it should have got stainless. And what that did is that went in here and around this idler pulley. And I had to make a shield real close so that if there was some slack in it, it couldn't get out of there and yet not get pinched. And then I used a piece of, okay, sorry about that. Battery decided to croak. Okay, I used a piece of brake tubing to guide that cable down the tube, and it hung down the center of the tower, and I had a weight up there if I wanted to shut the windmill down. It would just swing this tail over like so. And it actually worked pretty well. Matter of fact, I might try to retrofit that new one on the what's left of this one. This mount stuff here will all have to be changed. Oh, and the other windmills I had up there, I had slip rings on. And this one I just decided to run the cable down through the same tube and just, I mean, there's what, 50 foot of tower there for it to twist around, and it never bothered any. I never had to go change anything. So it twists and non-twists, and as long as you got enough slack, it worked great. When I had slip rings occasionally, I would have to maintain them. Something would go wrong, get out of place, or springs would go bad, or seemed like there was something all the time messing with them. So that solved that problem. So just thought I'd give you a quick look at the old girl before I convert it into scrap. So I think this is probably going to be a multi-part video, so I think I'll end this one here. So if you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please do. Thanks for watching. and we'll see you next time.